Hi students, welcome to today's video session, Standard Precautions or Standard Safety Measures, which comes under Microbiology Unit. I know that you all have studied the Standard Precautions in Nursing Foundation as well. So what is Universal Precaution? It is nowadays called as Standard Precaution, the set of guidelines designed to protect the healthcare worker from exposure of infection transmitted through blood and body fluids. What is standard precaution? It is a guidelines used to reduce the risk of transmission from recognized and unrecognized sources. So standard precaution is the precaution you take for all the patients who got admitted in the hospitals, irrespective of their disease or any infection. What is hand hygiene? Washing hands with soap and water or with antimicrobial hand scrubs. So what is PPE, personal protective equipment? We'll go to the topic. So what is the definition of standard precaution? According to Center of Disease Control, CDC, standard precautions are the minimum infection prevention practice that apply to all patient care, regardless of suspected or confirmed infection status of the patient in any setting where healthcare is delivered. So wherever the healthcare is delivered, whoever the patient is, whether they have disease or not, once they are in the hospital setting, we maintain some minimum infection prevention practice, which is called standard precautions. That means these are all the basic safety measures we take for the patient as well as the healthcare people. What is the aim or goal of standard precaution? The main goal of standard precaution is to prevent transmission from infection, okay, to patient, to healthcare workers, healthcare workers to the patient, patient to another patient, hospital environment to the patient, hospital waste to the community. So everything comes under the standard precaution. So there are certain principles we follow under standard precautions. What are all they? Hand hygiene, personal protective equipments, respiratory etiquette, appropriate patient placement, that is patient isolation, disinfection of environment, safe sharp handling, proper disposal of waste and handling of linen. So these all things comes under standard precaution. It includes all the engineering work, waste handling and the nurses basic protection like hand hygiene and PPE. The first one is hand hygiene. You all know there are 8 steps in hand hygiene as per WHO. You should, whenever you do wash your hands with soap or with hand scrub, you remember all these 8 steps: palm to palm, between the fingers, back to hands, base of the thumb, base, back of the fingers, fingernails, wrist, and rinse and wipe it dry. So 7 steps with washing. And you should remember always when we should do hand hygiene. There are 5 moments which is very, very important you should remember when you enter in hospital. So the first moment is before touching a patient. Whenever you are going to touch the patient, so before touching, wash your hands. The next is before doing any procedure. So if you are going to do any procedure, before that you have to wash your hands. The next is after doing a procedure or after handling any body fluids or exposure to body fluids, blood or body fluids. So after exposure to body fluids or blood or after a procedure, you will be washing your hands. After touching a patient, so once you touch the patient, before touching you do, and after touching you will do the wash. After touching a patient and surroundings, so if you are touching any of the patient surroundings also, you should wash hands. So it means you will be washing hands every few minutes. Okay, so before touching and after touching the patient, before doing any procedure, after doing the procedure or after handling any blood or body fluids, after touching patient environment. So these are all the 5 moments of hand hygiene you should remember. The next one is personal protective equipment. From the picture itself, you know what all the things comes under personal protective equipment, that is PPE. So what is the definition here? Personal protective equipment refers to protective clothing, helmets, gloves, face shields, goggles, face masks, and respirators or other equipment designed to protect the wearer from the injury or the spread of infection. So there are equipments which you will use to protect yourself from the other infection or illness or the injury. So this is PPE. So what, as a nursing aspect of view, what you should know about PPE is donning and doffing. So how you should, what is the sequence of donning and doffing the PPE? So you should wash your hands either with soap and water or hand rub, and then you wear the gown first, then the mask, then goggles or any face shield, anything, and then at the last you will be wearing the gloves. This is the donning sequence. And doffing sequence is, first you should remove your gloves, then your apron, and then goggles or face shield, and then mask, and then you will wash hands with soap and water or hand rub. So this is very, very important. You should know the sequence in medical nursing aspect as well as in the microbiological aspect. So you should know the sequence of donning and doffing. So next is respiratory etiquette. So what are the important thing to the patient you should teach as well as you should follow is, cover your mouth and nose with a tissue when coughing or sneezing. As you all know that we all should wear mask, try to wear a 3-layer double mask for the safer side. Use in the nearest waste receptacle to dispose of the tissue. So after, once you cough, the tissue paper or the things you use or the towel you use, you can dispose it to the nearest receptacle. Perform hand hygiene. Hand washing should be done with the soap and water or with the hand rub to prevent the infection. So these three are the very important aspect when you think of respiratory etiquette. And you should remember that you are not supposed to cough or cover your nose and mouth with the hands. You should always use your forearm when you cough. Okay, this is a source from CDC. The next one is cleaning and disinfection. Cleaning and disinfection, we should, as in the hospital setting, it is necessary that you should follow certain things. Cleaning of patient care devices, it needs CSSD for disinfection and sterilization. You all know that central sterile supply department is essential for a best hospital to run. So it will take over the disinfection sterilization activities. Use detergent and enzymatic cleaners. Clean with water and soap before sterilizing. So whatever equipments you use, if possible, it is better to wash it with soap and water before sending it for sterilization. Disposable items should be disposed. Check and do proper high and low level sterilization. So as per the equipments you use, you can use whether it is need a low sterilization or a high sterilization. Cleaning and disinfection of environmental surface, floors and tabletops should be cleaned on regular basis. Disinfectants should be used as per the manufacturer's instruction. The dilution of the disinfectant should be done as per the hospital policy. Handling of blood and body fluids should be, and spills should be properly done as per the protocol. Usually we use a bleaching agent to clean the blood and body fluids. Use PPE when doing cleaning. This is very important. When you are going to clean, you should use the PPE. The next is linen management. So how the hospital linen should be managed to prevent the infections. Linen cupboard should be locked when not in use. So when the linens are kept or stored, that cupboard has to be locked. Don't shake the linen, especially while you are changing the linen. You are not supposed to shuffle the linen. Do not leave any soiled linen on the floor. So you are not supposed to leave the dirty linen on the floor. You should use the bag. Avoid contact of one's body and personal clothing. Dispose soiled items in a water-soluble bag. So if it is wet with blood or any other fluid, body fluids, you have to separately pack it. Dispose non-soiled items separately. Contaminated linen should be handled with disinfectants as per hospital policy. So contaminated soil should be dipped inside the bleach or the disinfectant solution for a while and then send it for wash. Infected linen should be disinfected using the disinfectant solution. Use old sheet when expected soiling. So if you expect soiling in case of during that time, you can use old sheet, so you can throw it as a waste. Use Macintosh to prevent soiling of linen. So from the nurse's point of view, you should remember all these things when you handle the linen. The next is patient placement. This is very important, where to place the patient. So placing the patient poses a risk of transmission to others in a single patient room when available. So what you should do when it is available, you try to put them on a single patient room. But it is not available in all cases. So you should remember, whenever you place a patient, you remember these following things. Route of transmission of known or suspected infectious agent. Risk factors for transmission in the infected patient. So what are all the risk factors expected from the patient? And the risk factors of adverse outcome resulting from an HA, healthcare associated infection, anything will happen. For example, if patient is neutropenic, they have a high possibility of getting infection. So those patients has to be separated. That is, we say it as negative isolation. We move them from the people who are infected. And if they are going to give us transmit infection, then those patient has to be quarantined. Availability of the single room is very essential, and you should ask the patient's concern regarding the patient, I mean single room allotment. Patient options for room sharing is also very, very important. So personally, you should ask the patient whether they are willing to share the rooms before you put them on the sharing rooms. So you should always remember that the route of transmission and the risk factors of transmission and the risk factors of the adverse effect of the patient also you should check before putting them in the bed. The next is sharp handling, which is very, very important aspect from the nurses, because they are the one going to handle the sharps most of the time in the hospital. So what are the things you should remember when you handle needles? Avoid using needles whenever safe and effective alternatives are available. If there is any alternative available, better you avoid using needles. Avoid recapping or bending needles that might be contaminated. So don't recap the needle at any cost. Don't bend the needle. Bring standard labeled leak-proof, puncture-resistant sharp containers. So when you are going to give the patient a sharp container, make sure that you are giving a good sharp-proof leak containers. Do not assume such containers will be available there. So for example, you are sending a patient to home and he is going to take insulin from that day. So you can give a sharp container to the patient's family so that they can use it there. So don't believe that this sharp container is available there. So you should teach them how to dispose the sharp and where to dispose and how to keep it safe. Promptly dispose of used needles, device and sharps immediately to the sharp container. Plan for the safe handling and disposal of needles before use. So before starting the procedure, you should plan everything, including the disposal of the sharp needles. Store sharp containers out of reach of children, pets and other not needing access. Secure used sharps container during transport to prevent spilling. So better thing is that you close and lock the sharp containers when you are going to transport it to one place to another. Follow standard precautions or infection protocol as per the hospital policy. Participate in your employer's bloodborne pathogens training program. Help your employer select and evaluate devices with safety features. This is if you are an employee, then you should help them employer to select the safety devices. Use devices with safety feature. Report any needle stick injury or sharp injury immediately to the employer. So how you should handle the needle stick injuries? So if you have unexpected needle stick injury, you should wash immediately with soap and water. So the needle cut should be squeezed out and washed immediately with the soap and water. If the flush happens in the nose, mouth or skin, then you should wash with the splash of water and irrigate the eyes. If it is the eyes, then you have to clean and irrigate the eyes with water, saline and sterile irrigants. Report the incident immediately to the supervisor and immediately seek medical treatment. So if you are having a needle stick injury, immediately you should squeeze out the blood and wash the cut with soap and water. And if the splash is happening in the nose or mouth, you can wash it nicely. And if it is in the eyes, you should irrigate the eyes and immediately report the incident to the supervisor. Using sharp containers. So you remember the sharp containers, it should not be overfilled with the sharps because it will cause injury to the people who are cleaning or disposing the sharps. Dispose of sharps container according to your facilities guidelines when they are 2/3 full. So generally it is best to dispose the sharp or close the sharp containers at when it is 2/3 full. Never force a sharp into a sharp container. So don't overfill the sharp container and force it inside the sharp container. Never reach into a sharp container. Never open, empty or reuse a sharp container. So you are, once it is closed, never you reuse it. Don't try to open it. Okay, so it is better you can use another sharp box. So remember, you are not supposed to overfill the sharp or you are not supposed. So this is the quiz time where you will refresh your video session. You should change the sharp box when it is half full, 2/3 full, 1/3 full and full. When exposed to needle stick injuries, first thing you do is report to the supervisor, write an incident report, wash the site thoroughly with soap and water, wipe it off with towel. So put your answers in your comment section. Thank you for watching.